actually saw this concept, something like similar to this, down at Disney. If you're a big fan of like Walt Disney World, things like that, they actually have a new road system down by like downtown Disney and things like that, or what's now called Disney Springs. I still call it downtown Disney because that's what I grew up with. But if you go down there, you actually will notice that the buses turn into like the median when you're traveling through that area. And why they do that is because when they redid the road and stuff in front of it, they actually made in the median, two lanes for buses, just for Disney buses, one going each way. And so they still stop at traffic lights and things like that, but it's really just dedicated to Disney buses, and it makes the system a lot more efficient. So I kind of wish they would have something like that so that in City Skylines, so that we could do stuff like that. Unfortunately, they don't have those, and I don't know why, but that bus just drove over that grass. So we'll be getting there shortly. I love this view. Just kind of looking out over the city. It's a great view. There's some great points like this in Cincinnati where you can go to, I think it's Eden Park. You actually look over the Ohio River, and then if you turn, I think, right, you look back over Cincinnati, like downtown. Amazing. And there's a point in, so kind of a little bit more about me, I guess. In high school, every year they took a trip to Chicago. And so when I went, you know, went to Chicago, we stayed just outside of Chicago. And I still remember the hotel we stayed at. It was really odd because it was in the parking lot of a Subaru dealership. And so, you know, we would walk over and look at the cars and everything like that. But, like a view of Chicago, you would go about 2-3 miles on the highway and we'd always have to stop. But there's a corner you took, and I remember you went around the highway bend, and then just the whole skyline was there, and it was amazing. And I have some photos somewhere of it, and I was taking pictures of the skyline, and then about a mile or two down the road, there was the Union Pacific Yards, and at that time, I had never seen a Union Pacific train, because I lived too far east to really see them. And actually, to see them in person, they were kind of neat. So, I know a little bit of geeking out, and how, you know, when I was in, you know, was really big into engineering, things like that. I still am, but I remember the view, and it was just amazing, because, you know, growing up in Cincinnati, our biggest building is, it's the Great American Insurance Building. I can't remember how tall it is, but it's a decent sized building. It's probably 50 or 55 stories, so if it's like 500 or 600 feet. And then we go to Chicago, and it is, you know, you go to the Sears Tower, which I actually went out into what they call the glass boxes. I stood in one. I actually have a picture of my foot next to a bus. Like, the bus was on the ground. You can see my foot next to it, and the bus is about as big as my foot. It was amazing that, you know, engineering had gotten to that point. You know, it's stuff that we don't see every day, and I know the Sears Tower at one point was the biggest tower in the world. I mean, I'm thinking it was. But now that there's buildings that are taller than that, it's just incredible to me. It's something I really enjoyed. So, but yeah, let's go ahead and upgrade our Turbulent too, because we have our upgrades here. So we get the teacup ride. Is that what it said? Yeah, rotating teacups, or the, as my dad calls it, the mad hurl and whirl, because he cannot, for some reason, take any spinning rides at all. No, granted, I've been on, I've been on, like, the Mad Hatter's Tea Party. It's a pretty good ride. It's not one of my favorites, but it's still a pretty good ride. But my dad, for some reason, will get absolutely sick on rides like that. I remember when Dinoland USA came out, he didn't know what Primeval World Spinning Coaster was. And if you guys don't know what it is, it's a roller coaster. It's not a very big one, but it's a, I think they call it a, it's not a Virginia Reel. I think, if I'm not mistaken, it's called like a Wild Mouse Spinning Coaster. I think it's actually how it's labeled. And essentially, you get to the top of the hill. It's like a 4-wide kind of oval-shaped car, and you get up the hill, everything seems fine. But when they let you go off the drop, they actually, it's the ride actually, the car rotates as you go down the track. he didn't know this. And we got on there, and we got about halfway down, and he started feeling deathly sick. And we finally stopped, and I really thought this. I'm like, I had never gotten sick on a ride. You know, I've never seen anybody get sick on a ride up to that point. This is before I actually worked at the amusement park. And I thought I was going to end that streak that day. Thankfully, he didn't. That was probably the closest time I've ever seen him get sick on a ride like that. However, we'll say that that's not the only time I've seen somebody get hurt on a ride. When I was younger, you know, still a big fan of Disney, we used to go probably once a year. We were kind of the family. That's the only place we would go. And I don't know how old I was. I still remember it. So I was probably maybe 4 or 5. So this has been, it's probably 20 years ago now. And we were riding Dumbo's Flying Elephant. And if you don't know what that ride is, essentially, it's you sit in a Dumbo-esque car, you spin around, you have a little lever, and you control it up and down the whole ride. It's like a 30-second, maybe a minute ride. So we were riding it, had a great time, and we went to go get off of it. Well, the ride itself, it kind of sits on an arm. So you kind of sit, if this is the ride vehicle, you're sitting on an arm. And this still kind of bounces even when the ride is not going. My dad didn't pay attention, and he hooked his toe on there and fell flat on his face onto the platform. My mom started not freaking out, but she was a little worried. I was laughing. The ride operators were a little concerned. Well, he got himself up. You know, his knee was bleeding, but other than that, it was fine. Well, as the old saying goes, like father, like son. I didn't pay attention to what he did. I was laughing too hard. I tripped over the platform, fell flat on my face, just like he did. Knee scraped up, and I still remember the bench that we sat at is still there in the park. Even though they moved the Dumbo ride, it's still there in the park. From where it's at, I don't exactly remember, but I know when I see it, like, that's the bench. We had a couple of Disney medical team there. My mom was there with the first aid kit, and we were just trying to clamp our knees and make sure they would stop bleeding. Stuff like that, I'm like, oh, that is... It sucks, but it was just stuff like that I remember so much, and that's the reason I love amusement parks, because I have tons of stories like that. And, you know, it's stuff that I'll remember for the rest of my life, which is always neat, so... So yeah, that is the time I fell off a Dumbo. So now we have our access to Holly Branch, which I think that's... Now that I keep saying it over and over, I think that's what I'm going to name the city. But it was upgraded a little bit. Let's make it nice, because it's supposed to be... I'm trying to think here, because technically, if it's like a small town, something like that, we would really have 6 lanes, or would it be 4 lanes? Thinking maybe 4 lanes, something like that, and we'll just kind of bring it through town here, and then they wouldn't have a key here because small towns couldn't afford a key, but we could do something like this. I do kind of want to do something a little bit different here because. This really wouldn't be planned at all. As I'm thinking about this more, Holly Branch would be kind of like a city that kind of didn't really start out as it was like a fort at one point, and that fort became, it was like Fort Holly, and then became like a town. We can even put like a small fort along here, to be honest with you, like a preserving area. Because there is some old cannons you can put up, and that might be a kind of a neat idea. And then, so, this became, eventually, what would be called, or what we're going to be calling Holly Branch. And Holly Branch would be the town over here. Yeah, I think something like that would be kind of fun to do. Let's just mark it out here. It's not going to be called King District. Because that sounds very, official. This is going to be called Holly Branch. Yeah. So we'll put a police department and a fire department over here. Small one. But, you know, some nonetheless. And then we can put our water, if you look at any kind of, like, large city, something like that, 9 times out of 10, smaller cities will be buying water from larger cities anyways, so, you know, this kind of makes sense of why that we're connecting all the water up. I mean, even the town I live in, it's quite a bit away from Cincinnati, but I'm 95% sure they buy water from Cincinnati, so, you know, nothing too crazy there. We'll also run power over there. At the same time, probably not, you know, making their own power or getting it from somewhere else. So, there's that. Let's see here. As long as that should update the power here shortly. There we go. And now we can actually start zoning some. Maybe a neat little system. Also, one of the reasons I want to get back to Disney. I was hoping to go this year, but with how things are, I don't know if I'll get out there. I want to try Disney new gondola system. I don't. My mother absolutely hates the idea, but I think they're kind of a neat idea. They're different. I've been on a couple like this. Stone Mountain, Georgia has one like this. It's a lot of it. It's more like this one than actually gondolas, but I think it's a great idea. So I know they've had a couple issues with it, but you know, I have enough confidence in Disney to think that they'll have it. They have kind of the bugs worked out of it. I know they had the incident with it. They had a couple cars collide. People got stuck on it for a little while. I understand why they might be upset with that. But I think the reason people don't like it is that since they're using it to kind of cut bus services, which, I mean, you know, the gondola system is a lot more efficient way to actually run things. It just runs electricity, and whatever you can use to generate electricity is what you can use to run the gondola system. Whereas if you get something like buses have to take, unless they're a modified bus, which I'm pretty sure Disney has a couple of those where it runs either like on natural gas or biodiesel that burns cleaner. Those are really expensive to operate. I mean, monorail is even worse than that. But it's just, you know, trying to save money, and that's all they're trying to do. Like, I understand why they did it. I think it's a great idea, but I think just some people aren't quite on board with it yet, so. Start getting rid of more of Holly Branch or Holly Farms. Let's just get rid of the rest of it, actually. It's sad. It is. But, let's go ahead and do it. And there she goes. This unfortunate end for a great farming area. Now we can really redevelop this area into a great place for our government. I think what I'm going to do, do something like this. Alright, we're getting close. Getting close out to 50%. Essentially, when it's going to hit 50%, I'm going to put down the oppressive office, I'm going to put all of my police stations back, put a prison up, and I might even put a helicopter depot up. Just so that we can get the crime rate back down to like 4 or 5% like it was. Alright, we want to watch it hit 50, because, that's what we're kind of. There it is, 50%. Let's see if we can get our oppression office now. We cannot. What? Alright, hold on. Time out. What was the one we needed to get 50% on? The crime rate. Because I know there was one. Oh, we're going to maintain this for 5 weeks now. Right. Well, it looks like we were even planning on fast forward. We should probably have done that. hopefully, I thought it was the oppressive office. It's not. It's actually the courthouse, which, honestly, I think I'd prefer the courthouse over the oppressive office, but, you know, that's just me. It's unfortunate that you have to let your city kind of go like this for you to be able to get stuff like that, but, you know. Anyways, let's go ahead and start rezoning some of this commercial down through here. We'll also just go ahead and get rid of these housing. It looks like they got rid of them quick because they were like, too much crime, I'm out of here. And so we'll rezone those as high-density stuff. And that'll look really nice once we're starting. I think this whole area I'm going to redo up into Evergreen Terrace, which is this road right here. I think all this will be nice. It's high-density. Especially around like Trapezoid Park, I think that'll look really nice. And then, you know, we're trying to increase the land values as much as we can around here. I think we need probably a couple more parks up here. I think that'll help. Because, you know, if we can get this area to look like the only rich people would live up here, that's kind of what I'm going for. Kind of this exclusive neighborhood where, the rich and famous would live in our city. So it's starting to get that way too. But if you notice here, downtown is still very attractive to people. So that's kind of what we're looking at. All right, where was the courthouse at? We almost have our unemployment rate over. We're getting up to 15 already. Where was that at? I always forget where it's at. It's like, all right, well, I've spent 10 minutes trying to search for it. What is that? It's the Science Center. I do want to kind of put stuff like this around. So. There it is. Nope, that's not it. That's the oppressive office. Where is courthouse? That's the tax office. Lose the courthouse. That would not be a good thing. I don't think it's quite been 5 weeks yet, but I want to make sure that we get it. And I don't see it anywhere. And that's not good. Sinks. Library. Am I literally just blind? I don't see it. I have to go through just every one of these. Colossal Order Office, Office Park, Courthouse. Done. Probably get rid of some stuff though. So we can put it down in this corner here. Alright, pause the game. Let's get every police officer back to work. Because we need it. I know Evergreen Terrace have one. I know one here. I'm going to put a bigger one up here. Maybe we can use it up here. Also put one over here in the industrial area. Also put a prison up. Now... put a prison maybe right here? I don't know if I'd put one there. Yeah, I'm gonna put it out here by the farms. And that seems a bit odd. We have people, you know. But, I know... For some reason, they will put these prisons in the middle of nowhere. So if they do escape, there's not really that much around them to escape into, so that might work. That's also why I remember to, let's increase the police budget to 150% so we can get as many police officers out as we can. What is this thing? It's really nice looking buildings. I guess we can use that as like our city center. You know? hopefully quickly watch the... Holy, wow, we were up to 55% crime rate. So we can watch it rapidly decrease. Which is good. Yeah, we're starting to lose a lot more population, though. I noticed that. We're down to just under 19,000. We lost about 4,000 people. I don't know if it's because of the... It looks like we might be having a death wave in the middle of the, the crime sprees.